Students, yesterday about 17th group elements introduced about fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine and astatine and some important points of fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine and astatine explained. Your physical properties of halogens like fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine and astatine in atomic state is like in molecular state is F2, Cl2, Br2, I2. This is in atomic state only. So about these halogens, why these are called halogens, 17th group elements and occurrence of the 17th group elements. And some important points, general points about 17th group elements explained. Electronic configuration and atomic size, covalent or ionic size are the radius, ionization energy, electron negativity and affinity. Some important points of this 17th group explained, 17th group elements. Now, some important physical properties are these elements. First one is physical state. At room temperature, this fluorine and chlorine are gases. These are gaseous state. Your bromine is a Br2 is a liquid in nature, liquid state. Now I2, iodine is a solid in nature, solid nature. Now this iodine I2 in a solid state, it shows one important, a very good important property, that is sublimation property. What is sublimation? Right, iodine shows sublimation property. Your sublimation property, sublimation energy, sublimation process. Whatever it at room temperature, this solid iodine is directly converted into iodine vapors. Without converting into a liquid state, direct conversion of solid to gas or the solid to the vapors. Without enter or without converting into a liquid, that process is called the sublimation process, and the amount of energy required for the process is called a sublimation energy, SCE. For iodine at room temperature, some minimum amount of energy required at room temperature only, this iodine solid vaporizes, converted into a iodine vapors, just like naphthalene balls. It is a solid at room temperature. When are that naphthalene ball or room fragrance, any balls, odonil balls are exposed to the atmospheric air, they are easily vaporizes without converting into a liquid. That process is called a sublimation process. For that process, amount of energy required, that energy comes from where? From atmospheric air, from temperature, from atmospheric temperature, it absorbs, then converted into vapors. Now, between molecule and molecules, or between atom and atom, your top to bottom already explained, like between X and X, like fluorine and fluorine, your chlorine and chlorine, bromine and bromine, iodine and iodine. Bond length order bands increases. Between molecules and molecules like X2 and X2. This is the halogen molecule and halogen molecule are due to the presence of weak van der Waal forces. Between molecule and molecule, you are the weak van der Waal forces are there. due to the presence of weak van der Waal forces in this halogen molecule, top to bottom size increase between molecule weak van der Waal forces decrease, that easily vaporizes. Reason why it easily vaporizes, because there are iodine between weak van der Waal forces exist. That force is low, that force is very very less than compared to the fluorine, than compared to the bromine, than compared to chlorine. In iodine, that force is very very less, that easily vaporizes. Between atoms and atoms, here fluorine and fluorine bond length is less. They are attractive in nature, more covalent in nature. Your chlorine-chlorine size increases, covalent nature decreases. Now, between molecule means between fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, between molecule, van der Waal forces decrease because increasing this molecular mass, then force decrease, that easily vaporizes. That is physical state. These are the gases, these two at room temperature, it is liquid and it is solid. Then generally here second important point is non-metallic character. Non-metallic. So in this 17th group elements, almost all are non-metallic in nature, except astatine 80, because your 80 is a radioactive element. Slightly its non-metallic character decreases. From your fluorine is more non-metallic than compared to the chlorine, than compared to the bromine, than compared to the iodine. All are non-metallic, but compared to that, while comparing, this is more non-metallic than compared to the iodine. Decreases, like, clear? So your non-metallic and these are generally highly reactive non-metals. Highly reactive non-metals, that reactive nature also same order. More reactive than compared to chlorine, than compared to bromine, than compared to iodine. Now here, due to the presence of one valency unpaired electron, and to get a readily octet electronic configuration, these molecules exist as a diatomic molecules. Diatomic molecule means your halogen molecules, halogen atoms cannot exist. Halogen molecules means X2 like. Between atom and atom, 7 valency electrons are there. Out of 7, 1 is unpaired. That 1 unpaired electron is ready to donate. It forms a covalent bond to get the to attain the stable octet electronic configuration. Now gives like X bond X. Now this is molecular structure, Lewis dot structure. Here 2 electrons are there. Here it shares this X, shares these 2 electrons, and also these 2 electrons are shared by this X. So both are attains the stable octet electronic configuration. So, ready to get a stable octet electronic configuration, your halogen molecules, halogens exist as a diatomic molecules, and ready to attain stable octet electronic configuration. That's why they are highly reactive and non-metallic in nature. Clear? Then, very very important property is here about the halogens, color property. See it, color property. Color property of halogens. Your fluorine F2 is pale yellow or yellow in color. Now Cl2 is greenish yellow color it is. Now your Br2 is red color or reddish brown color. Now I2 is a violet in color, violet color. So the astatine is a radioactive element. Remaining all these are in gas or liquid or solid state exhibit some color property. This is in practicals in organic chemistry, chlorinated halogen atoms, any organic compound is present when are exposed to the atmospheric when are exposed to the non-luminous flame of the Bunsen burner, like this is the non-luminous flame of the Bunsen burner. To this non-luminous flame of the Bunsen burner, to this biasing spatula, if we can introduce chlorinated compound, organic compound, it imparts greenish yellow edged flame. For example, here C2H5 bond Cl, ethyl chloride. Take one liquid on spatula and expose to the flame, that is the non-luminous flame of the Bunsen burner. It imparts green edged flame. That green edged flame or a greenish yellow color flame indicates the given organic or any compound contain Cl. If it is bromine, yellow color. If it is fluorine, yellow color. If it is bromine, reddish brown or the red color. If it is iodine, violet color imparts. That is one of the most indication preliminary test to identify what type of halogens present in that organic or inorganic compounds. For example, here the NaCl is there, greenish, or NaF sodium fluoride, yellow color. Sodium bromide is there, that is reddish brown color. Like your NaI is there, iodine, violet colors. That is reason for this, due to the excitation of electrons from lower energy to a higher energy orbitals. So due to the excitation of electrons from lower energy level to the higher energy level orbitals, atomic orbitals, then it imparts certain colors. How it excites? Your fluorine or like chlorine or bromine or iodine, when are exposed to the atmospheric air, depending on type of photon. What is photon? Type of photon, that is called a quanta. Quanta energy is equals to h nu photon and h nu. Depending upon the type of photon absorbed from this sunlight or from a burner, depending upon the type of photon or the quanta is equals to h nu absorbed by these elements, it imparts different colors. So based on their frequency and wavelength of the visible light radiations, it absorbs that radiations absorbed by different elements, it shows different colors. So why fluorine shows yellow color, why not red color, means its capacity of fluorine absorbs the photons at an wavelength or the frequency radiations, at imparts certain different colors, like fluorine is yellow color, chlorine is this, bromine is this, iodine is this. That's why different photons absorbed by different elements, it shows different colors, not the same colors. Very, very important concept, color property of 17th group elements. The next one is some important simple points about 17th group elements, that is density, melting points, boiling points, bond dissociation energy and solubility. Very, very important. So here, next property is density of 17th group elements. Density is gram per centimeter cube units. Now, density is equals to, we know, mass by volume. Mass by volume. Now, here the fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, and astatine like. Now, here the top to bottom are fluorine to the iodine. Atomic number, what happens? Increase. Simultaneously, atomic number increase. Simultaneously, atomic mass increase. Simultaneously, atomic volume proportionately increases. So, due to the increase in atomic number as well as atomic mass, proportionately volume increase, total density increases. That's why fluorine is less than chlorine, less than bromine, less than iodine. That is density. Done here, melting and boiling points, both are the same order without any change. Melting and boiling order in kelvins are the same. Fluorine is less than chlorine, is less than bromine, is less than iodine, because top to bottom atomic number and mass increase, their boiling and melting points increases. Next one is solubility. Very, very important this is. Solubility of halogens. Now, your X2 is a generally X bond X. It is a non-polar. Non-polar in nature it is. There is no charges because both are having same electronegativity values. Generally, your F bond F, like F2 molecule, it is F bond and F. Both are having same electronegativity. Same electronegativity values means there is no charges, there is no poles. That's why they are non-polar in nature. Generally, solubility depends on like dissolves like property. Like dissolves like property, this is. Like means you are the polar compounds soluble in polar solvents. That is like. See, polar compounds soluble in polar solvent. Polar. That's why like. Now, your NaCl is a polar, that is soluble in H2O, is a polar solvent. Okay? Similarly, non-polar compounds or molecules are soluble in non-polar solvents. So, here halogens like X2, fluorine, chlorine, bromine, and iodine are non-polar compounds or the molecules which are soluble in non-polar solvents. Significantly, it is non-polar solvent, that is in chloroform, like CHCl3 chloroform, carbon tetrachloride, benzene, like carbon disulfide, acetol, like in this molecule, the readily soluble. But less significantly, it is soluble in water. So, are they negligibly soluble in water at room temperature? Because not significantly, less significantly, it is soluble in water. Halogens, when dissolved in water H2O, they are less soluble, not more soluble, not significantly soluble in water. Because it is a non-polar in nature, it is a polar in nature, like it is a polar solvent. So based on this, we can explain easily oxidizing property. Next, in coming important property, I'll explain oxidizing property of halogens. On the basis of solubility also, we can explain. I'll repeat once again this. Now, based on this solubility, whenever these X halogens are soluble in non-polar solvents, non-polar solvents. So here non-polar solvents means here chloroform, carbon tetrachloride. This is carbon tetrachloride, chloroform, carbon disulfide or benzene, like it is readily soluble, more soluble in nature, and these solutions impart some colors, imparts some colors, that is due to charge transfer phenomenon, not excitation of electrons. Very, very important. Some solutions, whenever halogens dissolved in such a non-polar solvents, it imparts some colors, that is due to the charge transfer phenomenon, not a DD transition, not a excitation of electrons. How it transfer means, this molecule halogens receives the electrons from solvent, it forms a coordinate bond, like now charge transfer from solvent to this molecule, then it imparts certain colors, that is due to the charge transfer phenomenon. Very, very important. Your solubility, based on solubility, your halogens are less soluble in water because it is polar, it is non-polar in nature, but readily soluble in non-polar solvents. Clear? Then next important thing is, very, very important, we can expect one question based on bond dissociation enthalpy. Here bond dissociation enthalpy, bond dissociation energy or enthalpy, that is we can express in kilojoules. Now your X2 is nothing but your fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, like this. Now here the fluorine bond of fluorine atomic size is like, now here the chlorine and chlorine like, your bromine and bromine like size increases, iodine and iodine again size increases. What happens, top to bottom atomic number increase, simultaneously atomic size increases, because newly added electron enters into a new main energy level. So between iodine and iodine, yeah, the size increases, like top to bottom. This is maybe nucleus, this is the iodine, like your nucleus. Here to air distance increases. Whenever top to bottom distance increases, this is ready to decompose, dissociate, less amount of energy required. So by using a simple analysis between fluorine-fluorine, chlorine-chlorine, bromine-bromine, iodine-iodine, based on their bond sizes, which one has a higher energy, which one required higher energy to break a bond between fluorine-fluorine or halogen atom and halogen atom? Between fluorine and fluorine, more amount of energy required, because they are a shorter distance, strongly attracted with each other. To break that bond, more amount of energy required. But whereas in case of iodine, less amount of energy required. Bond dissociation energy is nothing but the minimum amount of energy required to break a covalent bond between two atom of an elements. Exists between two atom of elements, some amount of energy required. So at the top to bottom size increase, bond dissociation energy would have been decrease. Originally by using this, your fluorine is less than, chlorine is less than, bromine is less than iodine, this is. Sorry. Personally, for fluorine is greater than chlorine is greater than bromine is greater than iodine. Personally, it is correct based on their sizes, but experimentally, this is absolutely wrong analysis. This is the wrong order of bond dissociation energies. The reason behind that, very important 2-mass question. The correct order is for Cl2 is greater than Br2, than F2, than I2. This is the correct order. Bond dissociation energy order. Generally, they'll ask why the bond dissociation energy of fluorine is less than chlorine. Give reason. Actually, it's just the same. So, actually, it requires more amount of energy because between fluorine, bond distance is less. Then attractive forces are more amount of energy required, but experimentally that fluorine molecule require less amount of energy than chlorine. The reason behind that, here in case of I'll explain here, in case of fluorine, even though small in size, there is a less attraction because your fluorine containing 7 valence electrons and remaining fluorine contains 7 valence electrons. Between fluorine and fluorine, there exists even a covalent bond. By mutual contribution, mutual sharing, it forms one covalent bond. Here remaining 6 electrons are there. Here 2 electrons, here 2 electrons, here 2 electrons. Now these 2 electrons are equally shared by these 2 atoms like, and also like this. So due to the small size of F fluorine, your occupied space is less between these electrons, and between these 2 electrons repulsion takes place. That is due to the inter-electronic repulsive forces. Inter-electronic repulsive forces, they are not strongly attracted, they are weakly attracted. That's why less amount of energy required to break a bond between fluorine and fluorine. So actually between fluorine and fluorine, small in size, they are strongly, tightly attracted, strongly bonded. But whereas in this case, particularly fluorine and fluorine, due to the presence of more number of valence electrons, and small in size of fluorine, between fluorine atom and fluorine atom, between electrons and electrons, repulsions takes place, not attraction, repulsions. That is called a inter-electronic repulsive forces. So due to the more inter-electronic repulsive forces, bond dissociation energy of F2 is less than Cl2 and Br2. This is very important reason. Give reason or why fluorine has less bond dissociation energy than compared to chlorine. Give reason. A reason is due to the more inter-electronic repulsive forces between fluorine-fluorine atoms than in chlorine-chlorine. That's why fluorine generally has less bond dissociation energy than compared to the chlorine and bromine. This is a very important question based on bond dissociation energies. Clear? Next one is, clear? Now another important point is variable oxidation states by halogen 17th group elements. variable oxidation na oxidation na states of a 17th group of elements. Now here the 17th group elements are like fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine and astatine. Okay, so here first element is fluorine. It always exhibit -1 oxidation state, always in all other compounds. There is no variable oxidation states for fluorine. So the fluorine always exhibit -1 oxidation state, always in all compounds. Fluoride compounds always exhibits -1, that is due to its small atom, small size, and high ionization, high electronegativity and high ionization energy. Compared to all known elements, highest electronegativity element element is fluorine. Its value is 4. So due to its small size, high electronegativity and high ionization energy, it always in its compounds exhibit -1 only. Do not exhibit variable oxidation states by fluorine atom. Then here chlorine, bromine and iodine, based on their combining capacity with the other atom of elements, it shows -1, +1, +3, +5, +7. These are the possible variable oxidation states exhibited by chlorine, bromine and iodine. Particularly, your chlorine, bromine also exhibit your +4 and +6 also in oxides or oxo acids. I'll explain these oxides and oxo acids. Now, these are exhibit in interhalogen compounds. What are interhalogen compounds? I'll explain. Interhalogens, oxides and oxo acids. Now here fluorine only -1, but chlorine, bromine, iodine shows -1, +1, +3, +5, +7. Chlorine also shows +4 and +6. How it exhibit -1, +1, +3, +4 and +7 oxidation states? I'll explain that by using their electronic configurations, how it excites, how it shows +1, +3, +5, +7 oxidation states by chlorine, bromine, iodine with the help of electronic configuration. I will explain it. Okay, listen carefully. Note on these three important points, very, very important points. These, based on their electronic configurations, here electronic configuration of 17th group elements, general electronic configuration is NS2 NP5 is the electronic configuration. There exists a ND also, except fluorine. Now, for example, here if it is fluorine, its electronic configuration is like, its electronic configuration is like, this is for fluorine, like. Your absence of d orbitals, absence of d orbital in its valence shell, your only this one electron is unpaired. This one electron ready to accept the electron from other atom of an element after gaining fluorine atom, it becomes F-1, fluoride ion, that is equal to neon electronic configuration 10. F is 9 electrons are there. Now atomic number is 9 only here, but a number of electrons are 10 electrons are present. F minus 1 and neon are isoelectronic species containing both are having same number of electrons in its atomic in its valence shell. So based on these, your F fluorine do not excite any electrons from lower energy level to the higher energy level, like there is no excitation, absence of d orbitals, do not show variable oxidation state, only one electron decays, that's why it shows always minus one oxidation state, always exhibit minus one. Whereas in case of chlorine, bromine and iodine, general electronic configuration, I'll write here NS2, here NP5 and ND is there here. Presence of vacant term, d orbital in outermost orbits. Now this is the general in ground state electronic configuration. It contains seven valence electrons, like depending upon the combining capacity. Now it ready to accept one electron. It shows minus one. Or if it is ready to donate one electron, it shows plus one oxidation state in ground state. Okay. If it is in first excited state, first excited state is nothing but your one electron excited from NP to ND. Now here NS2, NP4 and your ND1 electronic configuration. Here are two electrons. Here are four electrons are there, like these are the four electrons. And here one electron is unpaired, like these three are unpaired electrons, which are ready to donate. So in ground state, ready to receive one electron, minus one exhibits. Or if it is ready to donate electrons to the other group, these three unpaired electrons ready to lose, it forms plus three oxidation states. First excited state. Now in second excited state, second excited state, its electronic configuration is NS2, NP3, ND2 is the second excited state electronic configuration. Here three unpaired and here two unpaired electrons are there, like 1, 2. Here total five unpaired electrons are there. So in ground state, it ready to receive minus one, are ready to donate plus one, like here also plus one, but after donating this five valence electrons, it shows plus five oxidation state, plus three, plus one, plus three, plus five oxidation states. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then third excited state, in this third excited state, its electronic configuration is NS1, NP3, your ND3, your one electron unpaired, your three electrons are unpaired. Now here also three unpaired electrons are present. So finally 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now it shows minus one. According to this plus one, also plus seven oxidation state. Now in chlorine, bromine and iodine, in addition to the minus one oxidation state, it also exhibits plus one, like plus three, plus five, plus seven oxidation states. So based on this, we can easy to estimate its hybridization also. Already in 15th group elements, like PCl5 explained, like how it excites. Same similarly, your IF7 is there, like in this IF7, one molecule. in this IF7 molecule, that is interhalocene compound, this fluorine is always minus 1 because high highest electronegativity element small in size, compulsory iodine shows minus as a plus. So by crisscross method, by using this I plus 7 F minus 1, then we'll get I1 F7 means iodine in a third excited state. This is in third excited state 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. With this 7, you are fluorine. 7 fluorine atoms are covalently bonded. It forms like sp3d3 hybridization here. Here it is sp3d2. Here it is sp3d. Now it is sp3. So hybridization also we can easy to estimate sp3d3 because 3 orbitals are participated. In this IF7 also same thing, around I7 unpaired electrons are there, like these are the 7 unpaired electrons. 7. All these 7 are like this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, that is in third excited state. But here the fluorine contain 7 valence electrons out of 7, 3 are the pair, 1 is unpaired, like. Now this is bonded with iodine. Similarly, this is fluorine, this is fluorine, this is fluorine, fluorine, your fluorine, and it is fluorine. Now around iodine, how many electrons are there? Means here 14 electrons are there. Because 7 from iodine, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Remaining 7 are from fluorine, like to get the covalent bond. Total 14 electrons are present. Do not show any octet electronic configuration. It contain 8 electrons, then only obey the octet electronic configuration, that is a limitation. More than 8 electrons, 14 electrons are there. Do not obey octet, limitations of octet electronic configuration. But whereas in this case of fluorine contain 8 electrons, like these are the 6 plus these 2 electrons, 8 electrons are there. But according to optical electronic configuration in a molecule, central element containing 8 electrons, then only obeys the optical electronic configuration. That's why these IF7 do not obey any optical electronic configuration. Clear? Now, this is the variable oxidation state and excitation of electrons. While writing some molecules, interhalocene compounds, we want like excitation. Fluorine do not show like excitation because of absence of d orbitals. A very, very important concept. Wherever or whenever required, there I will explain a complete analysis about this excitation of electrons. Okay, next, last important, property is oxidizing nature of halogens. Oxidizing property of halogens. They are oxidizing nature of halogens. So this oxidizing nature of halogens we can explain on the basis of electronegativity, size, here hydration energy, here SRP values. SRP is nothing but S stands for standard reduction, potential values. So here what are what is SRP or RP reduction potential and also SOP oxidized potential under standard conditions, how to calculate? S stands for standard, R reduction, O stands for oxidized. Same similarly here reduction and oxidized both are having same values, just a sign only differs. How to calculate these SRP values or SOP values? We'll explain in electrochemistry in second year only. In electrochemistry, physical concept I'll explain. Don't bother about these SRP values. Just I'll give just a simple clue about this. So here oxidizing nature of halogens means your halogens are fluorine, chlorine, bromine and iodine, astatine, levet, radioactive element. Your strongest oxidizing agent is fluorine than compared to chlorine than compared to iodine. So to explain this oxidizing nature of these, some reasons are there. High electronegativity elements, small in size, high hydration energy, and high hydration energy of this, and higher SRP value of fluorine. This value is SRP value is denoted by E naught, that is 2.87 volts. V stands for volts. Now this value is E naught value is 0.54 volts. Only for understanding purpose only, higher value, lower value. Higher the SRP value, higher its oxidizing power. That's why it is the strongest oxidizing agent. So here in a solution like F2 acts as a strongest oxidizing agent. Strongest OA oxidizing agent it is. So on the basis of all these, like an important example is here. Here lower atomic number, halogen oxidizes higher atomic number, halide ion. Very very important this is halide ion. This is so the lower atomic number halogen oxidizes higher atomic number halide ion. For example, here the halogens are fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, like these are the halogen molecules. So compared to the chlorine and bromine iodine, lower atomic number is fluorine. Clear? Now that fluorine F2 react with NaCl, sodium chloride. Here are the two moles of sodium chloride. Sodium is plus 1. Chloride, it is not a chlorine. Do you know the difference between rin and ride? Now here Cl2 is a name is chlorine molecule. This is chlorine. Yeah, the Cl minus is chloride. Chloride ion it is. IDE, chloride and chlorine. Rin is a molecular state. It is molecule. Chlorine molecule. It is a chloride ion, ionic state it is. Now here lower member atomic number halogen, halogen means like this is the fluorine lower member, this is the higher member. Oxidizes higher atomic number halide ion, halide ion means this is the halide ion, oxidizes. See here. Your F is a zero oxidation state, but in case of chloride, Cl is minus 1, then it gives 2NaF, sodium fluoride plus Cl2 is formed, here it is zero. See here, fluorine molecules to 0 to here minus 1 is there, it is. What happens? Addition of electrons takes place. Addition of electron is nothing but reduction. In reduction process, the participated molecule acts as a oxidizing agent. That's why fluorine is less atomic number halogen atom, easily oxidizes higher atomic number halide ions. So, are the fluorine molecules to the fluoride ion, what happens here? Reduction reaction takes place. In reduction process, participated molecule or species acts as a oxidizing agent. Now your Cl minus 1 to the Cl 0. Removal of electron, oxidation reaction takes place. Now in this oxidation process, the participated Cl minus ion acts as a reducing agent, Ra. So here the molecule acts as the strongest oxidizing agent. Same for example, FaX as a oxidizing agent, whereas F minus 1 acts as a reducing agent. Same similarly, if you can take continuously like F2 is react with 2NaBr, sodium bromide, gives 2NaF sodium fluoride plus Br2. Here the Br2 gas is liberated. Here F2 reacts with 2NaI, gives 2Na of sodium fluoride plus I2 gas is liberated. For this connectivity link, I'll take one more. Here the Cl2 plus NaF. Is it possible reaction? Statements here. Lower atomic number halogen oxidizes higher atomic number halide ion. It is a atomic number is 17, its atomic number is 9. Lower atomic number oxidizes to a higher atomic number halide ion. That's why this is not possible. When it is possible means Cl2 combines with the NaBr. Is because it is 17, lower atomic number oxidizes higher atomic number 35, days bromine. See here, fluorine with the chlorine, bromine, iodine. Chlorine is with the bromine and iodine, NaI, 2NaI, adds 2NaCl plus Br2 is formed. Your 2NaCl plus I2 is formed. So, by using this same combination, here, I'll take one more important example is your Br2 reacted with 2NaCl is not possible. Why? This is the higher number, atomic number. It is lower. Compulsory here, what happens? Lower atomic number oxidizes higher. That's why it is not possible. Here, Br2 react with 2NaI. Now it is possible. because it is 35 only. So the 35 add here again 18. 53 atomic number. 53. So the lower atomic number halogens oxidize. Higher atomic number halide ion it gives 2NaBr plus your I2 is liberated. This is complete oxidizing nature of halogens. So on the basis of chemical reactivities, on the basis of electronegativity, small in size and hydration enthalpies, we can say F2 is the strongest. Same on the basis of SRP values, F2 is the strongest oxidizing agent. Okay, these are the some important points about 17th group elements, some physical and chemical properties. Last only one simple point, that is anomalous properties of fluorine. Anybody here identify anomalous properties of nitrogen already explained to you. Anomalous properties of oxygen also explained. Then right now in 17th group elements, anomalous properties of fluorine. Cl, anomalous properties of F2 fluorine means this fluorine shows some peculiar properties then comparing with the other members of the same family, chlorine, bromine, iodine like. Why it shows anomalous properties means due to its first thing is small size. First one is small size. Next one is high electron negativity and ionization energy. Then third one is unavailability of d orbitals. D orbitals in its valency shell. That is the main reason. And also here the low bond dissociation energy. Low bond dissociation energy of fluorine. Bond dissociation energy of fluorine. It shows some peculiar properties fluorine with other important elements. For example, one simple example I'll give here. So generally, the fluorine high electronegativity is there. Means it is generally more reactive. Generally has high electron negativity and ionization energy, and it is more reactive means acts as a strongest oxidizing agent than generally having Cl2, Br2 and I2. This is. So comparing the Cl2, Br2, I2, more reactive, high electronegativity and high ionization energy, strong oxidizing agent. But compared to the other elements, fluorine having a low bond dissociation energy, B. So the energy is very, very less, and it forms only one oxo acid, whereas other elements, Cl2, Br2 and I2 forms number of oxo acids. So there are these some important differences with the other members. Now here the HF is a gas. HF is a liquid in nature at room temperature. Whereas HCl, HBr and HI are generally gaseous in nature at liquid at gaseous state at room temperature. Why are they fluorine combines with hydrogen it forms HF like HCl, HBr, HI. Why the difference between these two means here in this case hydrogen fluoride and hydrogen fluoride there exist a intermolecular hydrogen bonds. So due to the presence of this intermolecular HB hydrogen bond, it is exists a liquid state, remaining these are gaseous state. There are some differences between fluorine and other important elements of 17th group elements. I'll clarify that how it forms oxo acids, only one oxo acid or remaining elements forms a number of oxo acids. There is an important concept in these oxo acids of 17th group elements. There I'll clear all the important points. I'll differentiate between fluorine and other elements. Mainly two most important question is this: why it shows anomalous properties? That is due to the small in size, high electronegativity and high ionization energy, unavailability of d orbitals and low bond dissociation energy than compared to the other halogens. Okay, clear? Read well. Maximum within 2 or 3 classes will complete the 17th also. Maximum, they are known as small unit, that is 18th group elements. I'll maximum within 6 to 7 classes will complete P block elements. Okay, read well, take care.